Many years ago, creating fancy business cards, flyers, invitations, and YouTube thumbnails was painful unless you were a master designer with excellent computer skills. It was tricky to make anything professional looking. That was until Melanie Perkins, alongside her boyfriend Cliff Obrecht and Cameron Adams, launched Canva. After hearing the word no from over 100 investors across the globe, Perkins got lucky while kite surfing with some venture capitalists who invited her to a pitch. Fast forward 10 years and the Australian-born business now sees 40 million users a month, spanning 193 countries, and has a valuation of $40 billion as of September. But what is Canva? How does Canva make money? And how has it grown to become one of Australia's most well-known businesses? Here's how it happened. What is Canva? Canva is a free graphic design platform that lets you create business cards, flyers, tickets, newsletters, restaurant menus, Zoom backgrounds, and logos, among many other things. It offers a freemium service where users can create for free, but must pay for more complicated edits and add-ons. It has a drag-and-drop interface, and designs can be customized quickly and easily, helping beginners to bring their ideas to life. Their goal is to get into every workplace across the globe. But that might leave you asking yourself, how does Canva make money? Well, they upsell their premium version, which is about $10 a month or $100 a year, and offers better features, stock photos, cloud storage, background removal, premium templates, and branding capabilities. Through Canva Enterprise, they target America's Fortune 500 companies to sell them design and editing tools. Now that we know what Canva is and how it makes its money, let's look back at the story of how Canva was founded. The story begins in 2007 with Melanie Perkins at the University of Western Australia, where she taught her fellow students how to use programs like Photoshop while studying for her Commerce and Communications degree, with some people needing an entire semester to learn where all the various buttons were. The lack of easy-to-use design software led to Perkins and her boyfriend, Cliff Obrecht, to design their own site, which was originally for school yearbook designs, called Fusion Books. It was a website that allowed students to collaborate and design their own yearbooks online, which they would then print and deliver to the schools across Australia, setting up their first office in Perkins' mum's living room. This niche approach helped the pair to understand whether or not their idea was needed and whether or not it was possible to achieve. The answer was yes to both, with the business growing and expanding internationally to New Zealand and even France. But the big break came in 2010 when Perkins met the investor Bill Tai, opportunistically when he came to Perth to judge a startup competition, who invited her to San Francisco to pitch her idea and connect her with his contacts. But the curveball was that Tai was a keen kite surfer, which meant the invitation to his Mai Tai retreat for investors and kitesurfing enthusiasts thrust Perkins and Obrecht into an opportunistic pitch with investors. They pitched their idea, which at the time was called Canva Chef, a pizza if you will, with all the toppings and ingredients like fonts, photos, and illustrations to design anything. That name didn't last long, however, and when one of the engineers explained that canvas was pronounced Canva in French, there was no turning back. Having never kite surfed before, Perkins said she decided to give it a go because she didn't have many connections or a network, so you just kind of have to wedge your foot in the door and wiggle it all the way through. But this is a skill that all business people must learn, and it helped to secure further investment needed to hire their growing team of tech engineers after years of pitching without funding. By 2012, with the help of their tech advisor Lars Rasmussen, the co-founder of Google Maps, the pair were introduced to Cameron Adams, the third co-founder. That same year, they closed their first funding round, which was oversubscribed at $1.5 million of outside investment, which was then matched by the Australian government to keep them in their homeland. By 2013, the site went live, allowing people to design online for free, to officially begin competing with the likes of Microsoft and Adobe. It was perfect timing, as businesses were changing their design plans thanks to the popularity of Instagram and Twitter, as everyone improved their online presence. In the first few months, they had 50,000 signups, and by 2014, they'd raised another $3 million primarily from Peter Thiel's Founders Fund as they hit 600,000 users. just a few years later, and Canva had significantly increased revenues. In 2017, revenues were at $23.5 million, but the company was still making a loss of about $3 million as they were truly in growth mode. By 2019, revenues hit $200 million and the funding round that year valued them at about $3 billion. As of today, however, Canva is worth more than 10 times that, at $40 billion, after they raised another $200 million from the likes of T. Rowe Price, Franklin Templeton, and Sequoia Capital in the run-up to their IPO, which is likely to be next year. It's impressive growth, but it has come with its difficulties. For example, until a few years ago, the editing tool was so clunky that only 5 engineers could work on it at any one time. Things were breaking constantly. They were also hacked, with 139 million users' data revealed, which encouraged them to set up two-factor authentication. Their most pressing issue, however, is that they're yet to truly master their corporate sales, with small, rogue teams using Canva rather than whole companies. And with competitors like Adobe, Microsoft, Figma, and Sketch, the market is not exactly empty. But Perkins feels like we've done an incredible job, and we've done very little compared to what we want to do. We've done 1% of what I think is possible, and our company mission is to empower the world to design, and we really mean the whole world. 85% of Fortune 500 companies are using the platform, with between $700 million and $1 billion in revenues. That success has sparked a $40 billion IPO, which is on the horizon. Most importantly, Perkins and Canva have solved the problem of shockingly tricky design tools, making it simple and free for anyone with an internet connection. Their brand values intentionally communicate a sense of openness to show that anyone can bring their ideas to reality. We want everyone to be able to enjoy the superpowers of being able to design. It's wonderfully human, empowering, and inspiring. And that's how it happened. Thanks for watching.